In this video, I will show you how to repair the shock absorber of a washing machine by yourself. I have a washing machine from LG, model VD12390NDK. Recently, it has started to jump and squeak. The shock absorbers are to blame. I don't want to buy new ones. Here, it is clear that the washing machine makes a squeaking sound while operating. It vibrates a little. It is necessary to figure it out. The problem is most likely with the shock absorbers. The left shock absorber of the washing machine is making a squeaking noise, indicating that it is in need of repair. In order to quickly and efficiently remove the faulty shock absorber, we carefully turn the washing machine onto its side and proceed to take off the shock absorber. Here is the defective and worn out shock absorber, as you can see. To remove it, it is necessary to carefully tap it out with a hammer. Here are the saw blades, as you can see. We carefully remove the upper blade from its position. We gently take off the shock absorber and observe the result. And here it looks like this. To disassemble it, you just need to remove one of the parts. And inside there is such an insert. This is the piston, this is the cylinder. Using a small screwdriver, it is necessary to remove this clip that secures the internal insert. We pry the ring out from both sides with a screwdriver and remove it. It has this visual appearance. Now, as you can see, the worn insert can be removed. It has this appearance made from some synthetic material, but we will take a regular belt and make the same one. Let's take a compass and measure the thickness of the insert. It is 3 millimeters. I found the exact same belt. It also has a thickness of 3 millimeters, but the material is much more reliable. It is leather, unlike this insert. Now it is necessary to cut out the same insert from this leather belt with the same width and length. I will carefully and precisely cut the leather using very sharp, powerful scissors. We place this insert, the leather, and start cutting carefully along the entire length. The leather quite easily cuts. Very easily. With good scissors, the insert can be made a little longer. It can always be shortened later. Here is the leather insert. One side is glossy, while the other side is rough. It is needed to insert the insert into the piston with the rough side. Now I will try it on to make sure it fits perfectly all around, and we will trim off any excess. If you focus on this insert, you need to cut just a little bit. I will be cutting very small pieces carefully and precisely to avoid cutting too much slowly. Now we carefully insert the insert gently into the cylinder so that it fits snugly and securely against the walls and rests against the limiter that is located inside. Here it is tightly pressed against the walls in its place, carefully and securely. Now it is necessary to lubricate it well, with precision and thoroughly. You can use machine oil, solid oil, or lithol, whichever you have on hand. I use this high quality Canon grease that was used before. It is extremely greasy and slides very well. It effectively lubricates the leather well to prevent the piston from seizing. And we will also very carefully and thoroughly lubricate the very important essential piston with an average amount, neither too much nor too little. I'll remove the excess. Now the limiter can be carefully placed in its position. It simply and securely fits into its retainers on the housing. Here is the limiter in its place. And as you can see, you can try to carefully insert the piston right here. The piston is initially inserted tightly, but over time it becomes more flexible. So don't worry if it doesn't just slide well right away. After a few washes initially, and then eventually, everything will all wear in nicely over time. The leather will settle into place a little, and everything will work well. Here, the shock absorber is repaired. It is dry. Nothing squeaks or creaks, and it can be installed on the washing machine. Installing the piston is even easier than removing it.
And let's thoroughly and carefully check the functionality of the washing machine we are setting it up.
Now, the washing machine operates very silently and quite acceptably. So the shock absorber is working steadily, and the washing machine is operating steadily.